Hey everyone. Hi, Minas, Kritika, Niranjan, Dr. Ansari, Devinder, and how many more we have? Sania, hi. Hi everyone. Okay, so I'm going to just upload. There was some issue with the, just could not upload the things quickly. So I'm going to upload now. Okay, so first of all, we are going to, start off right away with the classes, then we'll go to some more introduction. Okay, so here I'm Dr. Rohini, and let me just, first upload the file for you. Okay, there we have. All right. Okay, so today in this session, we are going to see the lymphatic system. Okay, so lymphatic system is what we are going to see. We also have Rahul and Rishabh who have joined in. And yeah, hello. Okay, so here is my little introduction. I'm Dr. Rohini, and you are on Unacademy platform. We are having special classes now. Special class, I had one this morning at 7:30 a.m. And that was, again, it was a very, informative class that we talked about a lot of osteology stuff there. And then now we have general anatomy. And very soon we are going to start many other things. We are also going to hold some FMGE, exclusively FMGE goers, exam takers. For them, we are going to have a batch and INICET also. So these students are going to be greatly benefited. So we are going to see some students from there in special classes, okay? Because I'm going to target those topics. So now here, let me just go ahead and start off with the class. Hey, Kalpana. Okay, so now what is actually lymph? Now, lymph, you know that it is tissue fluid. You know that lymph is tissue fluid. It is colorless. And anybody knows what is the smell of the tissue fluid? The lymph, whatever enters there, it is also called chyle, right? It is called chyle. You know what is the smell? How does it smell like? Anybody? It smells exactly like breath. Acetone smell. So this is one of the questions that was asked sometime back. It smell of acetone. And also you can say that it smells of something like rotten or rotten beer, some old beer. Okay, so it smells like that. So that is the smell of the lymph. Okay, it is colorless. And you know that interstitial fluid, interstitial fluid actually is released into the extracellular fluid. Okay, these are all extracellular fluid. About 2 liters alone is released from the cardiovascular system. So much is released into the cardiovascular system. All this has to be released, otherwise it causes edema. And this is drained into the system. What system? All this drained into the venous system. Okay, so there are different channels, and there is a complete different route through which it goes. It's not the lymphatic, it is not the venous system or the arterial system, it's completely the lymphatic system. So remember, lymphatic system. So what does it consist of? Let's go to the next slide and let's list out what are the things that it consists of. It consists of all these things. Let's just list it out. One is, it consists of the ducts. Pen is not writing. It consists of the ducts, it consists of the nodes and other tissues. Okay, in this one, there are primary and there are secondary. You can list some of them as primary, some of them as secondary. Can anybody tell me what are the primary lymphatic organs? Lymphatic organs. Which are the primary ones? Which are the secondary ones? Very, very important. Anybody knows? Manikya? Rudradeep? Anybody knows which is the primary one, which is the secondary one? The primary one is the bone marrow and also the thymus, okay, which produces the T cells and the B cells. So this is bone marrow and the thymus. Rest all of the things like the lymph node. You can list the lymph node and we can talk about spleen, yes, and also those which are NALT. You know, nasal cavity associated lymphoid tissue, all these are also part of the secondary. And what else, Niranjan, anything else you can list under the secondary? Anything else? So here we can also list adenoids, we can list, and we can also list the tonsils. And when it comes to the abdomen, we also have something called Peyer's patches. Have you heard of this? Peyer's patches. So all this comes under secondary. Okay. So primary is just bone marrow and the thymus. So remember, keep this in mind. So this is the, you know, main part of, or those things that are associated with the lymphatic system. It's also called immune system. Okay, immune system. All right, so now here, so now this is how it is formed. It starts with those capillaries. They are the lymphatic capillaries, and you can see that there are some lymphatic channels, and between those channels you also have lymph nodes. You have lymph nodes. So whenever there is too much of, you know, the debris from the cells, sometimes the lymph itself, the lymph node itself will get overwhelmed, and it will get, you know, overwhelmed and it will get swollen, and that's when we can feel the lymph node swollen in the neck region. We can very easily find, because it is very superficial compared to the other regions. Okay, so those lymph nodes, we can feel it very easily, especially when we have like pharyngitis, throat infection, or some infection. We can definitely feel the lymph nodes which are swollen. So that is when the lymph node itself gets overwhelmed. It is supposed to filter the microorganisms and bacteria. When there is too much of bacteria, the lymph node itself will get infected. So there is lymph node, and you can also see those trunks, and you can also see the ducts. Okay, so here you have all these things, and it is ultimately, it is going into the venous system. Okay, so from the heart itself, you have about, from the CVS itself, you have about 2 liters of lymph drained into the channels. Okay, so that much of waste is produced by them. And here you have, it's a one-way system. You should remember it is one-way system and allows the lymph flow from the tissue spaces into the blood. So from the blood, it doesn't get back into the cells. So it won't go backwards into the cells. It is only one way, because you know that cells are semi-permeable. Cells are semi-permeable. It doesn't allow the things to get back into the cell. It is only one way. It is only out or exit. Okay, so this is how you can see the lymphatic system, how it is distributed. You can see there are so many nodes in between and so many ducts in between. They're called all lymphatic channels. You can see the inguinal group of nodes here, and which drain all this perineum area, groin area, loin area, etc. And you can also see that all this abdominal region has all the, you know, intestinal nodes or intestinal ducts from the digestive system. And you also have some, you know, channels that enter and make a big balloon-shaped structure that is called cisterna chyli. Okay, this is called cisterna chyli. Cisterna chyli is at the level of L2, lumbar vertebra, L2. So this one, what happens to this? It immediately starts ascending upwards and forms a duct that's called the thoracic duct. Thoracic duct has to enter the thorax. How does it enter? There is a big barrier in between that is called the diaphragm. So it passes through the opening T12. So along with the other structures like azygous and abdominal aorta. So you, how do I remember this? I'll remember this as AAT. AAT passes through T12. Okay, so there is thoracic duct, there is azygous and abdominal aorta. All these three, there is abdominal aorta is coming downwards, azygous is going upwards, and thoracic duct is also going upwards or ascending upwards. So this goes upwards and then it will turn to the left side. So it shifts to the left side, and ultimately you can see that it enters the subclavian vein. Okay, so now here with subclavian vein, there is right and left side both. So you can see it enters the left side subclavian vein. Okay, so remember this left side subclavian vein it enters, and that's how you can see that the left side subclavian vein has an opening for this thoracic duct. So that's how the lymph is drained into the venous blood. Okay, so what happens on the right side? This is the right side. Right side, irrespective of what is happening on the left side, this half of the body, just right in the center, you see, there is the color that is shaded differently up to here, has got a different channel. So whatever waste is produced by this side has got a complete different duct, different system, which carries all the lymph. So you have cubital lymph nodes, you have axillary lymph nodes, you have cervical group of lymph nodes. All these lymph nodes are sufficiently, you know, they have all these macrophages inside them, and they are more than sufficient to combat whatever happens on the right side. So all that is collected by a different channel, and that drains into the right side subclavian vein. So you should remember there is no separate name for it. There is only name thoracic duct on the left side. So left side is, you know, connecting to the thoracic duct, and right side has got a lymphatic channel which has got no name. Okay, so that's how it is. And we can also see the opening. This is the esophageal opening where esophagus is there. And this is the aorta. So that's why we have shown the aorta also, so that you can, you know, get an orientation, because abdominal aorta, azygous, and the thoracic duct are always together. Okay, next you can see how is the organization of the lymphatic system happen. The organization of the lymphatic system, you can see it has starts through the lymphatic capillaries. Those small, small things what you saw, they're all capillaries. And they all form a capillary bulb. Okay, they have a small, you know, like a nodule-like thing that's called a capillary bulb. And these have got some valves there. That is where the filtration happens. So that is where the filtration starts. And then what happens? There are muscle fibers around these bulbs. They cause contraction of all these lymph and the bulb. And that's how the lymph is pushed into the ducts. So it goes into the ducts. Okay, so these lymphatic capillaries are all lined by endothelial cells. So these are some of the, you know, key things that you should know. What is it lined by? It is all lined by endothelial cells. Always the lining of the blood vessel is endothelium. The cells are called endothelium. These are nothing but squamous cells. They're all squamous cells. Okay, next you have capillaries. They all unite to form large lymphatic vessels, or you can also call them as ducts later on. So these vessels will form ducts, and these ducts are the ones which join together to drain into a single duct, and that goes into drain into the subclavian vein. Okay, and that's how it is formed. See, now all these ducts, you can see the whatever is collected, the lymph, it is also called chyle. So it looks like colorless. Okay, it is colorless, and something that smells like rotten beer or rotten acetone smell or breath smell. And all this from the capillaries, it delivers the lymph to the lymph nodes. And sometimes when there is too much of infection in that particular region, think that someone has abdominal cancer, some cancer in the abdomen, or some cancer in the perineum or some cancer in the neck. So what happens to that particular group of lymph nodes? It will become overwhelmed with the number of bacteria and it will swell. Just by feeling the lymph nodes, by palpating the lymph nodes, you can make out that something is wrong. Okay, so they return the fluid to the circulatory veins that is near to the heart, and there is right lymphatic duct on the right side, and on the left side you have thoracic duct. So that is what I showed just now. The left side one is called thoracic duct. Full left side of the body is entire left side of the body, including the limbs, including both the limbs, are drained by thoracic duct. And right lymphatic is only head, neck, and pectoral region, and right upper limb. Only right side, right head, right side of the neck, right pectoral region. Only that much is drained by right lymphatic duct. Okay, so next, about how much of, you know, lymph is there. About 120 ml of lymph flows into the blood per hour. So you can just imagine how much of waste we produce per hour. So about 120 ml of lymph flows into the blood every hour. And this is how you can identify the various structures. You can see the thoracic duct. What is the function of the thoracic duct? On the right side, you have right lymphatic duct. Okay, on the left side, you have the thoracic duct. So this is the cisterna chyli. If they had given in a different color, it would have been easy. So this is cisterna chyli because ultimately it drains into the subclavian vein. If you zoom it, you can make out it's actually given in green color. Okay, but it's very light, you know, difference between the blue and the green. So you can't make out properly. It is actually given in green color and the rest of the things are in blue color. So you can see the green cisterna chyli, you can see, and you can see all other structures. You can also see the azygous vein and you can see the intestinal trunk joining it. Okay, lumbar trunk, all this, right lumbar trunk, intestinal trunk, left lumbar trunk, all this will join the cisterna chyli. And ultimately, cisterna chyli, you know that it is at the level of L2. Okay, L2. So now here it ascends upwards and see how it is shifted to the left side. And then ultimately it drains and joins into the left subclavian vein. So you can see it collects the lymph from the trunks labeled below. So all these areas, it has all these trunks that drain into this. Left jugular trunk drains into thoracic duct. Then left subclavian also drains into thoracic. Then thoracic duct entering the subclavian vein, you can see. And you can also see left bronchomediastinal trunk. So all these are there on the left side. What about right side? Right side, we have right jugular trunk. And then right subclavian you have. And then right lymphatic and right bronchomediastinal. All those that are related to the right side is there. Okay, so this is how the arrangement of the thoracic duct is. So now here, where is the situation? Situation, you can see, where are the lymph vessels? We can see lymph vessels. Some of them are, you know, you can see the lymphatic channels on the skin. If you have a lighter skin like this, you can see, I don't know if you can see my skin, you can see all these green lines. What is that? That is all lymph. Okay, so there is deeper layer of skin, subcutaneous tissues, diaphragm. There you have lymphatic vessels. Then you have in the abdominal cavity also you have omentum. Especially in the digestive system, there are a lot of lymphatic channels because that is the maximum producer of the waste. So whatever produces a lot of waste, the lymphatic vessels will be more there. For example, you please look at all those things that is like urinary system, genital system, digestive system. These systems are the ones which have maximum number of channels. So here you have all these. Okay, so here except the alveoli where there is a exchange of gases, rest all are lined by this lymphatic vessels. Okay. So now here, now all those were the places where lymph is present, lymphatic channels are present. Where it is not present, Do we have it all over the body? No, we have only in those places. But in these places, it's not there. It's not present. So please look where it is not there. It's not there in the alveoli. It's not there in the bones. It's not there in the cornea. It's not in the central nervous system. CNS has no lymphatic channels because we have only dural venous sinus. Then superficial layers of the skin also, no. Okay, so remember, in the central nervous system, whenever there is an infection, the dural venous sinuses easily they can get affected. Okay, how would drain excess of proteins? That is, there is a barrier mechanism, blood-brain barrier. Blood-brain barrier mechanism is there. It will allow only certain things. Not everything can get into the blood. There are things that cannot be transferred, will never enter at all. Okay, so that's how it tries to maintain the integrity of the CNS. Even by chance, if something enters, it has to be drained into the venous sinuses. And that's how it is filtered. Sometimes the venous sinuses also will get infected. Okay. So, you know, you must have heard of thrombosis of the cavernous sinus. All that can happen. So, this is composition of the lymph fluid. The, whatever composition is there, you have to just see. There is 96% of water itself. Very little, you know, solids. We have a lot of proteins. We have in the form of albumin, globulin, clotting factors are there, antibodies are there, enzymes are there. All these are present. And there is also lipids, carbohydrates, amino acids, and non-protein nitrogenous substance like urea and creatinine. All these are part of the solid part. There is consisting of only 4%. Okay. Next, you also have inorganic substances like sodium, calcium, potassium, and there are some chlorides and bicarbonates. They are high concentration than in plasma here. Okay, there are so many cellular contents. Cellular contents, lymphocytes are very high. The lymphocytes are the maximum in this case. Okay, and also WBCs, because all the WBCs are very high. It is not white. It is not white. It is colorless. Okay. Many people just call it white. It is off-white or colorless. It depends on how, whether it is, you know, infected, not infected, body is infected. Otherwise, it is colorless. It is straw color, like urine color. Okay. Next one, lymph nodes. Lymph nodes are small glandular structures. Now, I told about all these ducts, what they're lined by, where they are present, where they're not present. What about lymph nodes? Lymph nodes are not channels. They are just, you know, in between, like speed breakers. There is a duct, there is a lymph node. There is a duct, there is a lymph node. What do these do? So whatever bacteria and other things enter these nodes, that is filtered to some extent, and it will bring down the number of bacteria and other things, because you have a lot of macrophages and other, you know, things that can engulf all these materials. And then whatever filtrate is there, that will enter or move further down. But that sometimes what happens, the number of bacteria or macrophages, the number of bacteria or, you know, whatever the pathogens are way too many, and that is not sufficient, you know, that is too much for these lymph nodes to filter. So that can also happen. So lymph nodes are small glandular structures located in the cores of the lymph vessels, and the lymph nodes are also called lymph glands or lymph nodes there. Okay, you can also call them as glands. So this is the structure of the lymph nodes. You have afferents and efferents. So you can see efferent channels, and there are afferent channels. All those are coming are afferents. And you can also see medulla part. You can also see cortex part. And here you can see subcapsular sinus. Okay, subcapsular sinus. And it also has a very nice capsule covering on the outside. And this is the medulla part. So this is paracortex, cortex, and medulla part. Okay. So this is how a structure of the lymph node looks like. and all these whatever blue things you can see, they are all aggregations of the lymphatic tissue. And you have seen, afferents, you have seen the efferents, and you also saw the paracortex and the medulla part. And these small lacteals are present in case of small intestine. They have special type of lymphatic capillaries. They are called lacteals. So you have to remember, where are the lacteals? They are present in the small intestine. Okay, so lacteals, what do? They just not only pick up the interstitial fluid, but also they pick up all those things that are excess, like the dietary lipids and some of the lipid soluble vitamins, which, see, many a times we take so many multivitamins and so many things that may not be required in that quantity for your body. Where does it go? It has to be removed. So your body needs detoxification. And these are the ones which will detox it. These are the ones which will remove it. So excess of anything is removed by lacteals. Okay? All right. So lacteals, that is the one. And then you have the lymph of this area has milky color. Okay? Due to the lipid content. And what Tarsika was telling was right, but only in this case. Okay? What area is this? This is the digestive system, or you can also call this as intestinal, intestinal ducts. So these ducts will have white color fluid instead of colorless fluid because of the presence of lipid or fat in them. So that's why you said white in color, but it is only here. Rest of the places is not white. The ones which are drained from the heart is not white. It is colorless. So here, what is the function of lymph nodes? You know that chylomicrons concentrate. Yes, it is because of the chylomicrons. So now here we have filter the lymph before it is returned to the blood. That is one function. And it also has all this defense mechanism through its macrophages and lymphocytes, which produce this, rest of the things, of course, we will study in the microbiology. What are B lymphocytes? What are T lymphocytes? And what are immunoglobulins? Everything you'll study in microbiology. But this is a general topic. So we have to remember all these are general stuff that we are talking. We're not going in detail, but we can go into detail with the advanced classes. Okay, we are going to have many, many more classes. So attend all my classes to see more advanced things. So here we talked about all those swelling of the lymph nodes we talked about. Remember, it causes pain. Definitely it causes pain. Unlike any other swelling of the soft tissue, the lymph node swelling will cause pain. Okay, so now here, most common cause of swollen lymph node is infection. So now lymph node situated near the infected area definitely swells. So that's an indication to say that the body needs attention. So here, these are some of the functions of the lymph. We have already listed what are the functions. Let's not again go through the same thing again and again. The lymphatic system, you know that it helps in defense against the pathogens, and also it maintains, and also it helps in distribution of the lymphocytes to the particular area where it is required. So this is some of the pictures where you can see, look at this line. Okay, so there is an inflammation here, lymphangitis. So inflammation of the lymph vessels you can see, and you can see common cause is the bacteria, Streptococcus pyogenes. So here, most common inflammation this is. And you can see red streaks throughout the skin, you can see. And here, filariasis. I'm from the place where I'm from the coastal side. I'm from Mangalore. So that place has got so many people affected with this filariasis. Okay. Lymphedema, all this. So this is lymphadenopathy. It's disease of or inflammation of the lymph nodes. You can see all the cervical group of lymph nodes. They're all swollen, become swollen and enlarged, and it will be definitely painful to touch. So now here, lymphoma. So lymphoma is something to do with the carcinoma. So it could be cancer originating either from the lymphocytes, or it could be the other tissues which are part of the lymphatic system. Okay, so all this could be the risk factors. Hepatitis B infection, HIV, all these could be the, people who are at risk. All right, so with this, we have some nice, information about lymphatic system. I hope you understood what is lymph, how different it is from the blood. Lymph is not the same color as the blood. Blood color is different, lymph is different. It is not venous blood, it is not arterial blood. But this is waste that is carried from different parts of the body and it is given to the venous system. And we take so many detoxifying things. There are many, even in Ayurveda, there are many herbs which can bring down the level of interstitial fluid collection in the different parts of the body. Okay, it will help move all these excess of interstitial fluid. So sometimes excess of interstitial fluid can cause edema. So there is a lot of drugs like that. I can give you a list of drugs. I can find out from my, Ayurveda friends and tell you what are the drugs that can, in Ayurveda, which can bring down all these kind of swellings. If there is anybody, get in touch with me. Join my Telegram group, Anatomy by. So we discuss a lot of anatomy related stuff. And you can also, send in your queries, questions regarding the subscription. You can definitely ask me. I'll tell you how to subscribe. If you're stuck at some point, I can tell you. And you can also use the code, without fail, use the code ROHINI10. Let's see what else we have. Quickly to see some more things. Okay, so now here is the credentials I have. I have my degrees from KMC Mangalore, that is Kasturba Medical College, Mangalore, which is located in Karnataka. If you happen to, anybody happen to get a seat here for any kind of course, don't leave. It is one of the finest universities. It is deemed university and it is located in the beautiful coastal region where you have nice beaches, nice things. And the Manipal campus of KMC is very, much close to the beach. It is like you get bored, you can go to the beach. It's that neat. Details not here. Thoracic duct, cisterna chyli, right lymphatic duct, details not here. Yes, it is not here because it is general anatomy. I will be doing advanced in few days, okay? So I will be catching up with all these things. So this is what we can do in general anatomy. We'll do in detail in gross anatomy, okay? So please be there for my classes. I'll be covering everything for you. So this is the other credentials, other degrees, PhD I have. I also got a medical transcription and MBA. And there is one course called Assisted Reproductive Technique. This is ART. If anybody is interested, you can join this and get a certificate. This will allow you to work in IVF centers and you can also do ICSI procedures, ICSI and IVF, okay? And you can bring some light in those people who don't have children or issues. Yes, I work as a freelancer. I'm also an embryologist. Yeah. So which I do when I get bored from all this. Okay, so this is the subtopic. We were talking general anatomy. Okay, especially it's very easy for those people who were in anatomy, who have studied histology, it becomes very, very easy. And if you have a background of biotechnology, it becomes easy. If you have knowledge of biochemistry, then also easy. Or OBGYN or anat. These people will be the best, hand-picked people for embryologist, profession. And it is very good paying also. You will get very good payment. With each procedure, you can earn up to 30 to 40K. The procedure will take only 10 to 15 minutes. That's it. You can earn this much money. Who doesn't want it, right? In your institution, working as MBA is teaching me. No, I don't work because I was working in USA. That's where I used my MBA and MT. I was in USA for 9 years. Now I work for a hospital and college. Okay. All right. So now here we have plus subscription. I'm more into teaching than, administration. I was in administration before. Now I'm more into teaching. So plus subscription is something this you can note down. 12-month subscription, you will get hard copy and printed notes. So if there is anybody who is a big savvy of printed notes, you should go for 12-month subscription. So there are many other things that you can access, like live classes and recorded classes. All these things you can access. So Tarsika, what do you want to be next? What is your goal? What do you want to take up? You seem to be very interested in, goal-oriented. So what exactly is your plan? What do you want to be? You want to be what? Which subject you are interested in? Do you like anatomy or something else? Okay, you like radiology. Okay, that is everybody's choice. But what happens sometimes when you don't have a plan A, going well, you should also have a plan B. You remember that? You should always keep two plans in mind. For radiology, you have to know head to toe, everything. For orthopedics, you have to know everything. Radiology, everything. Okay, so which exam are you writing? Are you writing FMG? Which one are you writing? Are you writing in December? Okay, all right. Okay, fine. So yeah, so all the basics and everything, you just give importance to everything. And when you have all this, don't leave anything. Don't underestimate anything, because sometimes very silly things will miss out. So just go on answering anything and everything that comes your way. And you have to keep one proper, curriculum and thing, and that should go parallelly. That should keep going. And this is another road. Okay, where you are going to answer the questions, where you are going to do. So anything that comes in, you should be able to attend. Your knowledge should be there, not just what you studied previously. It should always be there in your head. So anybody gives you a question paper and says, solve it now, you should be able to solve it. So you should be preparing in that way. So you can do it. All right. So here we have iconic and also, plus subscription. So you can see there is an Academy Prep Ladder. Both you'll get in case of iconic subscription. And you have special class features. Like you can see, we are interacting so much. That is the thing that we can see in, special classes. We can interact so much. And we can also, get people who are always attentive and they'll never miss a class. Even if they want to, they cannot, because they will get notifications. Okay, you'll feel that you should attend. And also, lecture notes you can get in the PDF form. Okay, so these are some of the QBank series that you can access. There is always, there is something that you have to note. There is limited time offer. There is final price that is, actually the price is changed. There is new price that has been introduced. I'll tell you about the new price. But this was the regular price before. There is 10% discount. All right. And we are very proud of our star learners. You can see all of them. These have scored really tremendously well. They have scored. And you can also get motivated by looking at their scores. And there is Target Next 2022 and also FMG 2021. Educators, you can see all their pictures, and there are new batches that are starting on 15th, that is just today. So parallelly, everything will be happening. You have to pick what you want. So these are some of the clinical examinations and procedures batch. And there is Boost Your Medical PG Preparation with 24 plus 4, 12 plus 2. So if you know what your goal is, you know exactly, what to pick, how much to pick, not get overwhelmed, like our lymph node. Don't get overwhelmed. So you just pick how much is needed and you know how much of preparation you need to get the seat in radiology, because radiology is number one. So everyone wants to be a radiologist, right? So later on, we just, you know, think, okay, if not radiology, I have a plan B. If the plan B doesn't work, you have plan C. But remember one thing, you can make money with everything. It's all in your hands. Okay, some of the very good radiologists also may not make good money, may not make a good name. So it again depends on completely you, just you. So this is, okay, fine, that is good. So if you are very goal-oriented, then you work towards it, and which you are doing. I can see that you are doing well. All right, so this is my code. If anybody is interested, do use the code, unlock code, go for subscription. There is plus and iconic subscription. There is also EMI options and all this. Okay, so please see the rates. It's not at all burdening at all. So you can go for all this. So with all this, all the best to you. Happy studying. Tarsika, do join my 9 p.m. class. We'll do some MCQs. Okay, we'll have some quiz. So as and when there are classes and quiz like this, you attend. So that will give you a refresh of your, you know, memory. You don't have to separately study anatomy. All this preclinical, you don't have to separately study. You can just attend all these and refresh. Keep refreshing your memory. Okay. All right. See you. Bye. Take care.